Hey yo guys, this is Yuari Mask and you guys are watching Yuari Mask at YouTube channel. I'm a bit close to the mic right now, so that's why my voice is going a bit heavy in the mic. This is my voice, I'm Yuari Mask. In this video, I'm gonna change your whole life as a gamer. This video doesn't contain any gaming video or any gameplay video. But this video will help you in almost every single aspect of your life. Because this video contains the root of every single problem you're facing in your game. Irrespective of the device you are having right now, irrespective of the fingers you are using right now to play the game. In almost every single video, people ask me to make a video on close combat drills or to make a video on sniping drills, something. So guys, let's go and have a look to the topics we are gonna discuss in this particular video. The very first thing is how to improve your gaming. The very simple and the basic question or the point, right? So have you ever asked yourself whenever you got died in PUBG Mobile? So we are actually focused on PUBG Mobile right now in this video, but you can use every single given instruction in this particular video at any kind of aspect in your life, at any aspect of your life. So the very first thing is how to improve your gaming. Have you ever asked yourself when you got tied every single time in PUBG Mobile that how could you tackle that situation in more possible better way, right? So the another point we are gonna discuss is how to make your mind play the game itself instead of your four or five fingers involved in the game. It's a bit more deep or a detailed point we're gonna discuss afterwards in the video, that how to make your mind play the game itself instead of your four or five fingers or the two fingers. Let's go to the another point, that is how to train your subconscious mind according to the situations, just like Chinese players. Have you ever watched the gameplay of the Chinese players? They play so well. I don't know the secret of them, like how they are able to play like that much good, but still. How to train your subconscious mind according to the situations? This will be the very main topic of our video. Another point is, as a final result, another point is how to become the bestest version of yourself. This video seems to be a bit more busy, a bit more boring, right? But believe me, this video will really gonna change your whole gaming career if you are a professional gamer, or your gaming experience if you are a normal gamer, if you play the game just for fun. So we are gonna discuss about it also, like how to become the bestest version of yourself or how to find the bestest version of yourself. So guys, now just mark my words, or just focus on to my words right now. What I'm gonna say, the thing I'm gonna say right now is figure it out is the main thing you're gonna work on, the very first thing, to find what stops you to be the bestest version of yourself. Is it the fear of getting killed by another person in that particular game, or is in the same game you are playing, or you are getting killed by another person, or you are not able to show your gaming skills? If you are getting me what I'm saying. Or is it the thing that you got so much scared when a whole squad is pushing at you and you are all alone in that particular building, and every single teammate of yours has been killed by another squad? Is it the thing that is stopping you to be the bestest version of yourself? Second thing is that you have to figure it out is how to stop or tackle these things which stop you to be the bestest version of yourself. how to stop these things or how to tackle these things. If you got so much scared and a whole squad is rushing at you, what you will do in that situation? You'll get died easily, right? But that is not the real you. You have to find the real you. You have to give your 100% in every single game, because you are also a same person, just like Athena, just like Scout, or every single bestest player in the PUBG Mobile history you have ever seen. You're also a normal human being, and they're also a normal human being. But the main thing, the main difference you have to find in between them and you. The whole thing, the whole process of becoming immortal in the game. I'm not talking about soul mortal right now. The whole process of becoming immortal in the game will go through, like, to figure it out. What are the bases of their gameplay they are playing right now? Like Scout, on which basis Scout is playing? What is his basic mindset when he is playing his custom matches or his classic matches? Or what is the mindset of Athena while he is playing solo versus squads? Right? If you're getting me what I'm saying. And the another point is, maybe you can say that this is the most important point I'm gonna tell you. Explore and observe the changes. Yeah, you got me right. Explore and observe the changes in yourself. What I meant by exploring. Exploring means, if you are playing PUBG Mobile, like this video is especially focused on PUBG Mobile. If you are a player of PUBG Mobile and you are not able to kill a whole squad every single time you got killed in 1 versus 1 or 1 versus 2 or 1 versus 3 or kind of 1 versus 4 when a whole squad is rushing at you. What I meant by exploring is just go onto YouTube and write in the search section of YouTube Japanese players gameplay or the Chinese players gameplay. You will gonna see the godfather level of gaming. So guys, the main motive to make this video right now is I'm facing so much depressed time, so much bad time since past few months, just because I was not able to kill even a single person in the game. I was not able to perform in the game I used to do before. So what I'm doing since last week, that changed my life totally, right? I'm gonna share my whole experience with you guys, like what I'm going through. And since last week, I'm into something. I'm into yoga, I'm into meditation, I'm into dhyana. And this really changed my life, man. Seriously, this really changed my gaming, even my gaming experience. Every single time I used to kill before, when I started yoga and meditation and dhyana, I used to yell at my teammates for no reason. I used to get more toxic when I killed in the game every single time before adopting these things, yoga, meditation and dhyana. I think these situations, maybe you guys are facing the same situation sometimes, right? So the thing I'm gonna tell you is roaming all around yoga, meditation and dhyana. If you want to see a practical change in your gaming, if you don't wanna get irritated every single time when you get killed or when you got killed in the game, if you want to find out the real reason why you got killed, and if you really wanna improve that reason, if you really wanna work on that particular point or that particular aspect, that why you got killed in that game, or how you can do much better than that, than the previous gameplay, then you must follow yoga, meditation and dhyana. You do not have to perform the heavy exercise in yoga exercises in yoga, right? You don't have to do the meditation for the hours and hours and hours. Just listen to me carefully and don't quit the video right now. How I am into yoga and how I am doing yoga, meditation and dhyana since past few weeks and how it changed my life, my gaming career or my gaming is literally priceless emotion or literally priceless results I'm getting through this. I just wanna share with you like what are the positive changes that came into me after adopting yoga, meditation and dhyana. I think meditation and dhyana both are the same kind of words or same kind of terms, but still I will say them differently because my kind of schedule or my kind of way in which I do perform these things is a bit different. According to the gamer, how to perform yoga, according to the gamer, how to perform meditation, and according to the gamer, how to perform dhyana is so much different than the normal yoga, meditation, and dhyana schedules. So let's go directly to the schedules, which really gonna help you improve your gaming experience, and to make you a better human being. Let's go. So here, what I'm doing since last week is I'm gonna share right now. The very first thing is yoga. I perform very simple kind of yoga. And I perform two yoga. The very first is Kapalbhati Pranayam. You can alter these yogas according to you, but still how I do perform yoga, meditation and dhyana. The very first thing I do perform is dhyana. So let's go to dhyana first. Okay. In dhyana, first of all, in dhyana, meditation and yoga, in three of them, in all of them, the very common thing is I just go to YouTube and search a soothing song onto YouTube and pick up any of the song on the search page and put my headphones on and play any of the song from them. Now, dhyana. How I do dhyana, how I perform dhyana. Now, how to perform dhyana is just take long breaths. Just sit straight, your back should be straight. Now just dhyan onto God, dhyan onto Om, or dhyan on anything. Now, the main thing is how to perform dhyana. Just take long breath. Take long breath and breathe out. Take long breath. Just give some time to your body, to your mind, to stay connected in a much better way. Now, after dhyana, I perform yoga. In yoga, I do not perform that much typical kind of yoga, just like Baba Ramdev used to do. I just perform two pranayam, that is, the very first is Kapalbhati Pranayama. I perform Kapalbhati. Headphones on, music on, and I do perform Kapalbhati for 15 minutes. Then I take a break of 5 minutes. Then again I perform Kapalbhati Pranayama for 15 minutes. Total of 30 minutes after taking the break of 5 minutes in 2 sets. The other pranayama, or the other yoga you can say, I do is Anulom Vilom. I do perform this yoga just for 15 minutes, that's it. Sometimes 12 minutes or 13 minutes, because this is way more difficult than Kapalbhati Pranayama. I do perform Anulom Vilom just for 15 minutes and that's it. This is enough. This is more than enough. Now let's go to meditation. What I do in meditation, headphones on, music on. Now my kind of meditation a bit changed, a bit different than the normal kind of meditation. Just become thoughtless, just thought of God, just thought of Om, this is the meditation we all know. But as a gamer, if you want to do meditation, your meditation should be a bit different. I'm gonna tell you right now. So if you want to change your game, if you want to be a good gamer, in meditation you can do one thing, just dhyan on a particular topic. Just think about every single situation when you got killed in PUBG Mobile. In meditation, just close your eyes and take your headphones on, music on, and just think of every single situation you got killed and just tackle them into your mind. Just tackle that situations into your mind. Like every single time a squad is, just for an example, a squad is pushing on you and you got killed in yesterday's match, right? So just think about that particular situation and now make your mind forced to think like you were able to kill them yesterday. What happens with that, how this will work, our mind will get used to do that situations, right? We have to train our subconscious mind, as I told you before, we have to train our subconscious mind. So just think about every tough situations you have been through since past few weeks or past days and just tackle that situations into your mind. Will surely gonna help you, will surely gonna help you in your gameplay, in your gaming. So these are the things I wanted to share with you guys. This video is really so close to my heart just because it changed my life, because since past few months I was feeling so bad, I was feeling so irritating or frustrating or frustrated. Yoga, meditation and dhyana just changed my life. In respect of gaming, in respect of being a good human. So this is it for today. This is it for this particular video. I really appreciate your patience that you watched this video till the end. Thanks for watching. I hope this video will really gonna help you in your gaming, in aspects of life. Thanks for watching.